Hello students, in continuity of chapter 8, today we are going to study about topic allergies, immune system of the body, human body, then diseases like AIDS and cancer, and alcohol and drug abuse. First of all, we are starting with allergies. All of you know about this word. What is allergy? It's actually response of our body immune system against some allergens. When we visit vegetable market, often we have experienced that about sneezing immediately. So it's a one type of response of our body immune system, and it is due to various allergens. And if we talk about particular what is allergy, it means that it's a exaggerated response of immune system to certain antigens which are present in our environment. This all substance which can cause allergies or response of immune system, they are generally known as allergens. They may be dust particle, aerosols, pollen grains, some fibers, as well as some other substance which can cause such a type of allergy. This all are considered as allergens. Antibodies produced due to this, it means this response, they are IgE types. You know about antibody types and IgE type of antibodies. So due to this type of response of immune system in our body, human body, this type of antibodies are produced. Why it is actually occur in our body? So at that time some chemical changes occur, and this allergy is actually due to secretion of chemicals which are known as histamine and serotonin from the mast cell. So generally when we come in contact with such a type of allergens, immediately our body immune system, it gives response to this type of allergens. This type of allergy is caused due to this type of allergens, and this type of response is known as allergies. Immune system in the human body. Now we are aware of what is immunity, various kind of immunity in our body system. So how this type of immune system is present or arranged in human body? If we talk about human immune system, it is generally made up of lymphoid organs, some tissues, cells, and soluble molecules. It's like antibodies. In our body, some organs, they are related with this immune system. They are known as lymphoid organs. Some are primary lymphoid organs and some are known as secondary lymphoid organs. These lymphoid organs are the organs where origin and maturation as well as proliferation of lymphocytes occur. These primary lymphoid organs in our body, they are of two types: bone marrow, which is present in our large bones, and thymus. It's a one type of gland present in our body. So these two organs, bone marrow and thymus, they are lymphoid organs which are known as primary lymphoid organ. After maturation of lymphocytes which are involved with this immune system, they migrate to secondary lymphoid organs. These secondary lymphoid organs, they are spleen, lymph nodes, tonsils, Peyer's patches of small intestine and appendix. So these all are considered as a secondary lymphoid organ where after maturation lymphocytes migrate. So bone marrow and thymus, they are primary lymphoid organs, and rest of the organs considered as a secondary lymphoid organ associated with immune system of human body. The secondary lymphoid organs, they provide the site for interaction lymphocytes with antigens. In our body, human body, lymphoid tissues are there. They are also located within the lining of respiratory tract, digestive tract, as well as urinogenital tract. And generally, it is considered as a MALT. It means that mucosal associated lymphoid tissue. Because it is present in lining of this type of tract like respiratory, digestive and urinogenital tract, and mucosa layer is present. That's why it is known as MALT, mucosal associated lymphoid tissue. In short, it is known as MALT. It constitutes 50% of lymphoid tissues in human body. AIDS. Full name of AIDS is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. All of you aware of this disorders, you have knowledge about its causes, symptoms, then prevention and cure. In our world, first time it was reported in the year 1981, and after that it spread worldwide and killing so many number of peoples. Microorganism responsible for AIDS, it is HIV. It means human immunodeficiency virus, and it belongs to group of retrovirus. How does transmission of this HIV virus occurs? So some reasons are there by which this transmission of HIV virus occurs in human being. First is sexual contact with infected person. So generally, when a person which is infected with HIV virus, a normal person come in contact with this type of person, sexually contact, at that time chances of infections are there. Second is transfusion of contaminated blood and blood products. Suppose person, it needs blood transfusion, and if donor is suffering from HIV and the blood is not tested properly, at that time so one of the possibility for HIV infection. Third is sharing infected needles as in intravenous drug abuses. It's actually this type of facing or common problem in some clinic or hospital. It may occur this type of sharing of infected needles from one infected person to another normal person. So such a type of infection is possible in this case also. Fourth is infected mother to her child through placenta. As we know, the child during the development of fetus is associated with mother body with placenta. If mother is infected from same virus, HIV virus, so chances of infection in her child is there. So generally this type, four type of reasons mainly responsible for transmission of HIV virus in human being. One common understanding is that AIDS or HIV, it does not spread by physical contact. It occur only and only, or it spread when body fluids come in contact with infected person to normal person. At that time chances of infections are there. Immediately the symptoms are not developed in the body of infected person. It takes long time, and so generally symptoms, they may be vary from 5 to 10 years of time lag. For diagnostic test of AIDS, one test is common, that is ELISA test. ELISA test means enzyme linked immunosuppressant assay. This ELISA test is efficacious. It proves that the person is suffering from AIDS or not. So ELISA test is a diagnostic test for AIDS or HIV. And a person suffering from same disease, it means HIV or AIDS, okay, at that time generally treatment is provided, it's with antiretroviral drug, because it is due to infection of this virus which belong to group of retrovirus, and this drug is partially effective and just prolong the life but not prevent the death. So we can understand how this disease is actually dangerous to human being. This figure, it gives out clear idea about replication of retrovirus. When a normal person is infected or come in contact with this retrovirus, how development of this virus take place in the body of human being. First of all, when retrovirus is a group of virus, it's a belong this HIV virus from same group, it infect the normal cell. After that, this develop this viral RNA is introduced into cell, which is a normal cell. So introduction of this cell virus infect cell come in contact with normal cell, and then after further development take place, and this viral DNA incorporate into host genome. This way, after this contact with host genome, new viral DNA is produced by the infected cell. Then the normal genome of this human being, this normal cell, now it is changed. The new viruses are produced this way in body, and infection gradually develops. So this new virus now can infect other body cell. So this way, in human body, when this type of virus, retrovirus, come in contact with normal cell, at that time it is incorporated with host cell, host genome, its replication process take place, and these viruses can infect the other body cell also, and this way develop this disorder. Generally, when this type of cysts occur, and we talk about the disorder, this cancer, it is due to tumor. When cancer disease occur, at that time the tumor also develop, and it is necessary to know about the tumor developed during cancer disorder. This tumor are of two type of tumor, that is generally benign tumor and malignant tumor. The difference between this benign tumor and malignant tumor, first of all, let's understand about it. In benign tumor, it develop and remains confined to the affected organ, but malignant tumor, it spreads to other organ of the body. In benign tumor, rate of growth is usually slow, but in malignant tumor, the growth is very rapid, or fast growth also we can say. In benign tumor, there is no latent stage, but in malignant tumor, is latent stage is observed. Benign tumor can cause limited damage to the body, but malignant tumor, says actually cancer cells migrate to site other side of the body also. So this way, comparatively, malignant tumor is very harmful to body. In benign tumor, there is no metastasis, but malignant tumor, there is metastasis is also. Actually, when this type of tumor formation take place, then come into contact with other body also and start a new tumor formation, and this type of property is known as metastasis. Benign tumor, they are non-cancerous, but malignant tumor, they are cancerous. So this way, we can come to know about the different kind of tumor. Generally, it is benign tumor and malignant tumor. Now some causes of cancer. Actually, cancer is a uncontrolled cell division or uncontrolled cell growth also we can say. It causes by various factors. This cancerous neoplastic cell may be induced by physical, chemical and biological agents, and this all are considered as a carcinogens. It means that factor by which cancer is caused, they all are considered as a carcinogens. They may be physical, chemical or sometimes biological agents also. Cancer causes viruses, they are known as oncogenic viruses, and their gene is known as viral oncogenes. So the main reason behind cancer is due to such a kind of genes present, oncogenes. Cellular oncogenes, they are known as C onco or proto oncogenes. They are identified in normal cells, which when activated under certain condition, stimulation take place, growth and development take place, and it could lead to oncogenic transposition of the cells. So this way the transformation of normal cell into cancerous neoplastic cell occur in the body, and it is due to various type of carcinogens. This oncogenes may be this oncogenic viruses. These genes are called viral oncogenes. Cellular oncogenes and proto oncogenes are there. They are identified in normal cells. So this way normal cell of the body, they are transformed into cancerous cells, and it spread in the body, limited organ or some other part of body also. Now some tests or some techniques related with cancer detection and its diagnosis. Actually, early detection of this disease, cancer, is essential, and it allows the disease to be treated successfully in many cases. The cancer detection is generally based on biopsy and histopathological studies of the tissue of this infected area, blood and bone marrow test for increased cell counts. Radiography, computed tomography, it means CT, magnetic resonance imaging, that is MRI, they are also very useful to cancers of internal organ of the body. So generally this type of techniques, they are introduced for treatment, detection and diagnosis of this disorder. Now some treatments related with cancer. Actually, the common approaches for treatment of cancer are generally maybe surgery, radiation therapy, immunotherapy and chemotherapy. First, surgical treatment of cancer. In this technique, cancerous tissues are removed surgically. So the main affected part or organ of the body which is infected by this cancerous cell, it is removed by surgical method from the body. Second is radiotherapy. Here in this therapy technology, tumor cells are irradiated lethally by radiation. So radiation is provided to kill such a type of tumor cells. Third is chemotherapy. In this technique, drugs are used to kill cancerous cells. It shows its side effects also. It is generally hair loss, anemia. You are also aware of this thing. Generally, chemotherapy, it shows its side effects. Immunotherapy. Here, patients are given with alpha interferon, which activate their immune system and help in destroying the tumor. So this way, this main kind of treatment related with this disorder, cancer, is there generally surgical, radiotherapy, chemotherapy and immunotherapy. Drugs and alcohol abuse. All of you are aware of this thing, that is, what is drugs and alcohol abuse. Generally, these drugs, they are actually product of various plants and their various body part of the plant. This actually, this reason is due to concern with this harmful effects, and for this actually proper education and guidance it is required to youth. The plants, which are actually some product of some plants, its parts, leaf, stem or flower, generally their extract or latex is collected and it is used as a drug. Opioids, cannabinoids and coca alkaloids, they are obtained from flowering plants and a few from fungi also. Let's study this type of drug one by one. First, opioids. They are the drugs which bind to specific opioids receptors present in our CNS. It means central nervous system. As you know, our brain is associated with this, and gastrointestinal tract. Second is heroin. It is commonly also known as smack. Chemically, it is diacetyl morphine, which is a white, odorless, bitter crystalline compound. It is extracted from the latex of poppy plant. Here, the plant is actually Papaver somniferum. Its local name is poppy plant. From its latex, it is collected. It is taken by snorting and injection. The heroin is a depressant and slow down body function. So generally, this all type of drugs, they are actually allosteric effect in the body, and this way the various plants and their product, they are useful as a drug nowadays. Cannabinoids, they are group of chemicals which interact with cannabinoid receptors present in the brain. Natural cannabinoids are obtained again from plant, that is cannabis sativa, and particularly which part, that is inflorescence of the plant cannabis sativa. So this group of drug cannabinoids, it is obtained from plant cannabis sativa and specifically from its inflorescence. Then some other, it include marijuana, hashish, chorus and ganja. Generally, this type of various drugs, they are taken by inhalation and oral ingestion also, and they are known for their effects on cardiovascular system of the body. So this way, various kind of drug, they affect various body part of the human body as well as our CNS also, and it is taken various way. Coca alkaloid or cocaine. So also one type of drug which is obtained from coca plant. The scientific name of this coca plant is Erythroxylum coca, and its native is actually country South Africa. So coca alkaloid or cocaine is collected from coca plant. It interferes with the transport of the neurotransmitter, which is known as dopamine. As you know, in our nervous system, this type of neurotransmitters are there, and one of these is dopamine. Cocaine, commonly called coke or crack, is usually snorted. It has a potent stimulating action again on our CNS, it means central nervous system. It producing a sense of euphoria and increased energy. Adolescence and drug abuse. Generally, a person says this type of habit of drug abuse or addiction of drug, it begins from the adolescence stage in his life. Adolescence stage is a period during which the child becomes mature. All of you students, you are also right now is passing through this adolescence stage, and this is generally between the age group of 12 to 18 years. During this stage, actually in body physically changes occur, and this way some causes of drug abuse related with this stage of life. These causes are generally curiosity. So this child passing through this stage, actually they are having this type of curiosity in this age group. Second is, it is like adventure. Third is excitement. Fourth, experimentation. And fifth is stress or pressure to excel in examination. So generally, person passing through this stage, that is known as adolescence stage, it means age group of 12 to 18 years, the chances of this type of drug abuse is more. And some causes like curiosity, adventure, excitement, experimentation, and stress or pressure during examination, they are main causes of this drug abuses. Some effects of this drug or alcohol abuse. Some common effects are reckless behavior, malicious mischief, violence also sometimes, drop in academic performance, as well as depression, isolation, aggressiveness, and some other effects are also which are due to this drug or alcohol abuses. So this kind of effect of this alcohol or drug abuse, immediate adverse effects of drugs and alcohol abuse are there. They are commonly observed in person who is taking such a type of drug or alcohol. Some changes in behavior of this person, mischievous, sometime also violence, as well as drop in academic performance. And some common effects are depression, isolation, aggressiveness, and some other common effect. Generally in this age group, that behavior of such a type of person is actually challenge for his family as well as society also. As we know very well, prevention is always better than cure. So it holds this true here also. During the prevention and control of alcohol and drug abuse also, dependence is the tendency of the body to manifest a characteristics and unpleasant withdrawal syndrome if regular doses of drug or alcohol is abruptly discontinued, that include anxiety, shakiness, nausea, as well as sweating also. Prevention avoids undue peer pressure, education and counseling, seeking help from parents and peers, seeking professional and medical help. So this way it is useful for prevention and control of this type of drug and alcohol abuses, and particularly during adolescent stage. So this way one can prevent from such a type of effect. In future it is very harmful. This person suffering from this alcohol or drug abuse, it also this type of person, he becomes addicted to this drug. It means that can't live without taking such a type of dose of drug or alcohol, and ultimately in future it is very harmful, dangerous for his mental and physical health, as well as sometimes lethal also.